Good morning to you all. Today, in this video, I would like to discuss about set. And in previous class, you have learned already basic concept of set. And in this year, we learn some extra properties of set. So let's start. And today's topic, first, one more time, we'll try to see the definition of set, universal set, a new overlapping set, disjoint set, and complement of set. We'll discuss only these five topics in this video. So let's start. First, you know, set means well-defined collection of distinct object. Well-defined collection of distinct object. Well-defined means you can count individually, you can identify. And here distinct object, that means repeated number or repeated anything you cannot collect. Distinct object, that's why it is mentioned here, distinct object, well-defined distinct object. For example, see here, and remember this, a set always denoted in a curly bracket or second bracket, always set. Set is denoted by in second bracket or in curly bracket. It is necessary to present in second bracket. Otherwise, it will be wrong. And any set is denoted by any capital alphabet A to Z. Any alphabet you can use, A to Z. See, this is an example. A set A and all the element it is written A, B, C, D till J. That means you can identify, you can count. That means it is well defined. That's why it is a set. But see, collection of Prime Minister of India. Prime Minister of India. It is also a set because you can count. You can count all the minister name. One by one you can count. That's why it is a well defined. And distinct also. So this is also a set, but see, collection of your friend, collection of beautiful girl, collection of handsome boy, collection of good school. So this kind of word you cannot find out exactly. Good, beautiful, handsome, like this. We cannot identify because it's depend on person to person. It's vary always. So that's why that all are not well defined. That's why this all are not a set. And next one is universal set. See here, this is set, well-defined distinct object. Universal set, you know, universal set is the set which contain all the element of other set. That means it is a larger set. And you can say all collection of other set. And it is denoted by capital U or fix. See here, A is given this one, B is given this, C is given this set. So collection of all the element of the set of A, set of B and set of C is called universal set. You can see here, this is universal set. And if you'll see all the element present in universal set, A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A is a subset of U, B also subset of U, C also subset of U. That means universal set. Clear? Universal set is a bigger set. It's contain all the element of other set. It's contain all the element of other set. Okay? Now next, overlapping set. This is very important and new one also. See, overlapping, that means two set. See, how many set? Two set. Having at least, that means minimum, one element in common. One element you have to find out at least. It can be 2, 3, 4, but minimum one element you need common in both set, A also, B also. See, for example, A is this given set and B this given set. And just you try to find out in between these two set, which element is same. I think you got it, that is 8. See, this 8 and here also see 8 is given. That means only one element is given here. That is 8. 8 is a common element for both set. Set A and B. That's why A and B both are overlapping sets. Clear? You have to find out minimum one element in common into both set, then only you can say this is overlapping set. It can be, listen, it can be two common element also, three also, five also, but minimum one. Clear? This is overlapping set. Now disjoint. It's a very simple disjoint. No common element. Disjoint, it is written disjoint. Two set having no element in common is called disjoint set. For example, this is A set and this is B set. You cannot find out one single element also common in A and B. That's why A and B are disjoint set, because there is no common element. There is no common element. That's why they are disjoint set. They are disjoint set. Now complement of the set. Complement of the set. Listen here. Just try to go through this definition. The complement of a set A is the set of all the elements in the universal set which are not in set A. It's denoted by this A complement, and it's written as complement of A. I would like to explain with example. Universal set is this one, and A set is given this one. So without A, left all the element you have to collect, and then only you will get complement of A. See here, in universal set 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But see here, A is given 3, 6, 9. So without 3, 6, 9, rest all the element will be present in complement of A. Clear? Rest all the element will be present in the complement of A. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7 and 8. Without 3, 6 and 9, rest all the element will come in the set of A complement. It's clear? This is the complement of the set. In this video, only this much. And next video, I would like to explain again many different properties with a diagram, Venn diagram. With the help of this, you can complete this first practice. I try to complete that. And take care. God bless you. Thank you.